people have to live in unity.
We are still in transition.
Civil society has been decimated.
Of course we rely on media.
And I think the government has not done enough.
The international community has failed to respond.
No place in the world is perfect.
Yoga event is held here.
Severe injustice and they should be stopped.
We should raise our voices.
Condemn this brutal act.
Hello viewers, welcome to Newsweek South Asia, a program that talks about the breeding of terrorism and its impact on South Asian nations. Let's begin with the headlines first. Lashkar-inspired terror module busted in Kashmir. Pakistan's two-nation theory incites Islamic radical terrorism, says POK activist. Islamic State attacks Sikh temple in Kabul. And Pakistan advancing terrorism in Afghanistan and India, says a US report. Unveiling Pakistan's vicious agendas in Kashmir, Indian security forces this week busted a terror module inspired by Pakistan-based Lashkar-e-Toiba in Kupwara district of Jammu and Kashmir. The forces also recovered incriminating materials from them, suggesting a possible Pakistan-sponsored terror attack in Kashmir in near future, a report.
Averting a major terror attack in Kashmir, Indian security forces recently busted a module of Lashkar-e-Toiba's shadow outfit in Kupwara district of Jammu and Kashmir. A search and cordon operation was launched after receiving a specific input about the presence of terrorists in the area who were looking for new recruitments by misleading the gullible youths of Kashmir to revive terrorism in the valley. Security forces arrested six terrorists and recovered incriminating materials from them, suggesting a big terror plot being carried out in the valley from across the border. The recovered materials include 8 AK rifles, 25 AK magazines, 10 pistols, more than 1,000 AK and pistol rounds, 89 hand grenades and 21 detonators.
Specific input tha hamare paas ki yahan pe kuch log hain jo terror module ka kaam kar rahe hain. और वो लोग नई रिक्रूटमेंट करना चाहते हैं और टेरर एक्टिविटी में तेजी लाना चाहते हैं।
Six terrorists were arrested in a two-phase operation, where initially the Indian security forces arrested four terrorists, and based on their information, a fresh joint counter-terrorism by Jammu Kashmir Police and Indian Army was launched in Kupwara district of Jammu and Kashmir, from where two more terrorists were arrested and more incriminating materials were recovered. The six were members of the Resistance Front, a newly formed terrorist outfit believed to be a shadow group of the LET.
उसी इनफॉरमेशन पे हम लोगों ने एक कल कहीं पे नाका लगाया था कल शाम के वक्त तो वहां हमने चार सस्पेक्ट्स को पकड़ा जब उनको राउंड अप किया और उसके बाद उनकी जो सर्च उनको कंप्लीट किया तो उसमें हमें 12 ग्रेनेड्स और एक पिस्टल उनसे मिला उन चार लोगों से उन्हीं की इंटरोगेशन प्रिलिमिनरी इंटरोगेशन के बाद हम लोग उन्होंने जब बताया कि ये कंसाइनमेंट हमें कुपवाड़ा की तरफ से मिला है तो हमने अपनी पार्टियां कुपवाड़ा भेजी फिर वहां पे कुपवाड़ा पुलिस और अलॉन्ग विद सिक्स आरआर के तहत साथ हम लोगों ने एक ऑपरेशन जॉइंटली लॉन्च किया वहां पे और उसमें फिर हम लोगों को काफ़ी बड़ी तादाद में जो है ये डिटेल आपके पास भी है मैंने शायद शेयर भी किया आपसे जिसमें काफ़ी बड़ी तादाद में AK-47 हैं और AK-74 हैं बाकी आईडी का मटेरियल है ग्रेनेड्स वगैरह हैं पिस्टल्स वगैरह हैं तो वो हमने रिकवर किया है वहां से
द टेररिस्ट रिवील्ड ड्यूरिंग इंटरोगेशन दैट दे वर वर्किंग अंडर अ पाकिस्तान बेस्ड मैन हु गोज बाय द नेम एंड्रयू जोन्स ऑन सोशल नेटवर्किंग मैसेंजर ऐप दीस फोर वर द मेन हैंडलर्स डिप्यूटेड बाय एंड्रयू जोन्स फॉर रिक्रूटिंग लोकल यूथ फॉर टेररिस्ट एक्टिविटीज इन कश्मीर पर्टिकुलरली इन नॉर्थ कश्मीर Their job was to instigate local youth to join terrorist ranks. One of the arrested terrorists, Sharafat Ahmed Khan, disclosed that he, along with two other people from Kiran, received a consignment of arms and ammunition from across the LOC and dumped it in Kupwara. The whole group was working to revive Lashkar's terror operation in the valley to disrupt the prevailing peace in the region.
मेन मोटिव इन लोगों का था कि लश्कर को यहाँ पे रिवाइव करा जाए अपने जेंड के में पर्टिकुलरली वैली में और ख़ासकर सोपोर एरिया में, और उसी के तहत ये लोग काम कर रहे थे और एक्रॉस हैंडलर्स के रबते में भी थे। फर्दर इन्वेस्टिगेशन हम लोग अभी कर रहे हैं।
पुलिस ऑफिसर्स इन्वॉल्व्ड इन द इन्वेस्टिगेशन इन्फॉर्म्ड दैट दीज ग्रुप्स हैव बीन वर्किंग अंडर द कमांड्स ऑफ फॉरेन हैंडलर्स फ्रॉम अक्रॉस द LOC एंड वर लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू कैरी आउट एन अटैक इन द हार्ट ऑफ कश्मीर दैट इज द श्रीनगर सिटी।
नॉर्थ कश्मीर खासकर सोपोर और संभल एरिया बहुत दिन से शांत था और दोनों इसलिए महत्वपूर्ण है कि यह श्रीनगर सिटी के आसपास है। अगर वहां मिलिटेंसी बढ़ेगी तो श्रीनगर सिटी पर अटैक होने की संभावना रहती है।
The arrest of the terrorists and their overground workers and recovery of weapons and explosives has foiled the designs of their masters to revive terrorism in Kashmir and unleash a fresh wave of violence. Meanwhile, the Pakistan Army continued with its infiltration attempts by violating ceasefire agreements at the LOC. This week again, villagers of northern Poonch district of Kashmir alleged that Pakistan fired shells targeting residential areas and a mosque. According to the villagers, Pakistan resorted to unprovoked heavy firing in Shahpur village of the district, to which the Indian Army also retaliated in appropriation.
बहुत हैवी फायरिंग पाकिस्तान की तरफ से इधर हो रही है, जर्द के पास हो रही है। हमारा इधर दरगाह है तो इधर जर्द के पास मतलब लग रहा है गोला, पाकिस्तान से लग रहा है। तो ये हिंदुस्तानी आर्मी ने जवाब दे रही है, लेकिन हम पाकिस्तान खामोश नहीं हो रहा है, चुप नहीं हो रहा है।
Pakistan has always used terrorism as proxy to wage a war against India. While the situation in Jammu and Kashmir is returning back to normalcy, Pakistan has intensified its efforts at increasing the strength of terrorists in launchpads along the line of control to create havoc in the region. Such consistent attempts by Pakistan at fomenting trouble and breaching harmony in an otherwise peaceful Kashmir reek of its duplicity.
Moving on, Pakistan has not just failed in improving the lifestyle of people of the illegally occupied regions of POK and Gilgit-Baltistan, but has ensured that these people live under a constant state of abject poverty. The policy paralysis has forced it to explore other options in order to control the region. While on one side, it has brazenly used disproportionate force to subjugate the common public of the region, it has tactically put one religion against another to dampen the spirit of communal harmony on other. Activists around the world have called out its hypocrisy on several occasions, but it has ignored them like anything. Today, we show you how the activists living in exile are asking it to mend its behavior.
A UK-based Kashmiri activist has accused Pakistan of exploiting natural resources and meting out atrocities on people of Gilgit-Baltistan and POK for over 7 decades. Highlighting the incident of 22nd October in 2018, when Pakistan police forces baton charged the innocent locals and activists who took out a peaceful rally against Pakistan's illegal occupation in Muzaffarabad, the activist condemned the heinous act that left many severely injured.
22 अक्टूबर को इस साल जब पीपल्स नेशनल अलायंस, जो कि 26 पार्टीज और ग्रुप्स और इंडिविजुअल्स का एक अलायंस है, डेमोक्रेटिक अलायंस है, जब उन्होंने कॉल दी मुजफ्फराबाद में कि हम मुजफ्फराबाद जाएंगे और वहां पे अपने मुतालबात रखेंगे, तो विद इन आवर्स उनके ऊपर इतना शदीद लाठी चार्ज किया, और उसकी वीडियोज़ मौजूद है जिसमें आप देख सकते हैं कि बाई स्टैंडर्स को पुलिस वालों ने पीछे से लाठियां मार के उनको बेहोश किया। 4 लोग वहां पे शहीद हुए, 150 से ज़्यादा लोगों को गिरफ्तार किया, 100 से ज़्यादा लोगों को डिसअपीयर किया वहां से। और उन्होंने फिर जब प्रेस क्लब में उनकी क़यादत जो थी उसने जाके वहां पे अपनी जान बचाने की कोशिश की, तो पुलिस ने प्रेस क्लब पर हमला कर दिया।
The activist outlined that the two-nation theory proposed by the Pakistani leaders was the basis of communal hatred among the people in Pakistan-occupied Kashmir. He further blamed successive governments of Pakistan for infiltrating terrorists and inciting violence in the region.
پاکستانی آرمی جو ہے وہ ٹو نیشن تھیوری اس کی آکسیجن ہے، اور کوئی بھی ایسی چیز جو ٹو نیشن تھیوری کو آبیاری کرتی ہے یا اس کو ہیلپ کرتی ہے گرو کرنے میں یا اس کو گہرا کرتی ہے، اس کے لیے جو ٹو نیشن جو پاکستان آرمی ہے وہ کچھ بھی کرنے کے لیے تیار ہے۔ اسی لیے انہوں نے کشمیر کے اندر اتنے سال آتنک پھیلوایا تاکہ یہ ثابت کر سکیں کہ جی ہندو اور مسلمان اکٹھے نہیں رہ سکتے، حالانکہ مسئلہ تو ریاست کا تھا، لیکن انہوں نے تو ریاست کی کبھی بات نہیں کی۔ انہوں نے تو یہی کہا کہ کشمیر میں مارے گئے مسلمان، کشمیر میں مار دیا، ہندو فوج آ گئی، حالانکہ مسئلہ جو تھا وہ پوری ریاست کا تھا جس میں پی او جے کے، گلگت بلتستان، لداخ، جموں، وادی سارے شامل تھے۔
The activist also warned the public of POK that Pakistan can play the two nation theory card any time and would activate terrorists to stage communal violence in the region.
Two nation theory ka card khelte hue wo ye sabit kare ke ye Kashmir jo hai ye India ke sath nahi rehna chahta, lihaza wahan pe wo incite karenge violence apne terroriston ke zariye. سب کانٹیننٹ میں ایک پیسفل ڈائیلاگ شروع کرنے کے لیے سب سے پہلے ٹو نیشن تھیوری کو نگیٹ کرنا پڑے گا۔ یہ ایک فاشسٹ تھیوری ہے، یہ ایک تھیوری ہے جو بنیاد بنی ہے نفرت کی پورے برصغیر میں، اور پھر اس سے آگے پوری دنیا میں 70 سالوں میں جو چیز پیدا کی ہے ٹو نیشن تھیوری نے وہ انٹرنیشنل اسلامک ریڈیکل ٹیررزم ہے۔
The two-nation theory proposed by Muhammad Ali Jinnah, the first Governor General of Pakistan, had later became the fodder for inciting communal hatred amongst the Muslim and non-Muslims residing in erstwhile princely state of Jammu and Kashmir.
Instability is prevailing over Afghanistan as the country is reeling under a three-way fighting. While Taliban have been storming Afghan military bases even after the peace deal, now the Islamic State have targeted civilians, that too from the minority community. The group launched a fatal attack on Sikh religious shrine that killed over 20 people and left many injured, a report.
Gunmen and suicide bombers raided a Sikh religious complex in the Afghan capital of Kabul on March 25th, killing 25 people. Following the gruesome attack, the security forces killed all of the terrorists. The Islamic State terrorist group claimed responsibility for the attack in a statement released hours after the attack.
Baraz Ahmad bola ami chize chasara ke bodi ake kise koshe marda budan khorzade bud mara megam mama payan shita ke payan meshadam zat ba farqish mar mizat dega dosto bud خانم من دختره کی خورده من نازدانه من مرا پدر پدر صدا کده جان دار.
The attack lasted hours as the gunmen held hostages while Afghan special forces and international troops tried to end the siege in a complex that is home to many families as well as place of worship. Up to 200 people were trapped inside the temple when the attack began at about 7 a.m. interrupting worship that had started an hour earlier. The attackers reportedly threw grenades and after bursting into the complex started shooting indiscriminately.
Saat after sob gud ke az daramsalay al undui ma sadai ag infijar shunida shod baadan sadai fire kalashinkov marmi va badat bomb disti wi gapa daga baad az intari daga ambulance wi gapa amad ami زخمی هایشان و مرده هایشان ها بدر بردن به شفاخانه. شدت انفجار به شدت بود که بدر اینجا دکان های ما شیشایش بسیار تکان خورد و خانه های ما بدر لرزات بسیار زیاد کرده گرد.
Following the early morning attack, Afghan Interior Ministry spokesman Tariq Aryan informed, without mentioning the number of attackers, that the operation by the security forces was over and all of the attackers had been killed. The attack was condemned internationally and across much of Afghan society. Afghanistan's tiny Sikh community is one of few religious minorities in the country protected by law but frequently targeted by extremists and subject to discrimination.
Har guruh terroristi ke zida dakhil basha حمله بر مکان مقدس و افراد ملکی جنایت جنگی است.
The attack comes a day after the United States said it would cut aid to the government by $1 billion over frustrations that feuding political leaders could not reach agreement and form a team to negotiate with the Taliban. An official with Afghanistan's NATO mission said the response to the attack had been led and executed by Afghan forces, but they had received some advice and assistance from NATO.
All sorts of terror-related instability and chaos in South Asia is an outcome of Islamabad-sponsored terrorism in the region. A US research report published a few weeks back is of the view that Pakistan prefers a weak and destabilized Afghanistan than a strong, unified state, as it gives Islamabad an upper hand over the country. The report also mentions that Pakistan's selfish interests in Afghanistan and illicit involvement in Kashmir is leading to increasing terrorism in the region.
A research report released by the United States Department of State accuses Pakistan of maintaining double standards in the matters of Afghanistan. On one hand, it voices support for political reconciliation in Afghanistan, but on the contrary, Pakistani establishment have not restricted the Afghan Taliban and the Haqqani network from operating in Pakistan-based safe havens, says the report. Taking note of India's long stand on terrorist groups like Lashkar-e-Taiba and Jaish-e-Mohammed, the report condemned terrorist attacks on India with the support of PAK agencies.
I don't see any change when it comes to terrorism and the state support of terrorism, neither on the domestic level nor international level. Here I will say that the Pakistani government still identifies not only the security circles, speaking about military and ISI, all the civilian governments see cross-border terrorism, particular terrorist activities in the Indian Kashmir as a foreign policy asset. So this has not changed yet, also in terms of when it comes to Afghanistan, when you see the latest terrorist attacks and all the manner, the whole manner they got conducted, is a clear indication that Pakistan has a certain policy also in Afghanistan by using terrorist assets.
Further pulling up Pakistan on its undeterrent resolve in letting the unlicensed Hawala money transfer systems to operate throughout the country, the report says that the money transfer system is being openly abused by terrorist financiers operating in the cross-border area. It illustrated the inefficiency of Pakistani government while stressing that some madrasas in the country still taught extremist doctrine and umpteen of them are yet to register with the government.
They are out of the blacklist as of now, but that does not mean that they are out of trouble. They are still in trouble because now it is just a matter of 4 months and they have got to take all those actions to curb terror financing and to take action against those individuals who have been placed on sanctions by the world body, like Hafiz Saeed, which they have not taken even now.
A congressional research service that also released along with US State Department report recognized Pakistan as the most important neighbor of Afghanistan, playing an active, but by many accounts, a negative role in Afghan affairs for decades. Pakistan's continued request in past for release of security assistance and its facilitation of the US talks with the Taliban had received a major embarrassment when US State Department in April 2019 had stated that the US administration has not seen Pakistan taking sustained irreversible actions that would warrant lifting the security aid suspension. It noted that Pakistan's security establishment, which is fearful of a strategic encirclement by India, apparently continues to view the Afghan Taliban as a relatively friendly and reliable anti-India element in Afghanistan.
And with that, we come to the end of this edition of Newsweek South Asia. We will be back next week with more news, views and analysis from the subcontinent. Meanwhile, do keep writing to us at nwsa@aniin.com. This is Surbhi Sharma signing off on the behalf of entire production team of Newsweek South Asia. Goodbye and take care.